Good day, everyone. This is JJ with Merit Plumbing from Sarasota, Florida, and I just wanted to do a quick video today talking about backflow preventers. So right in front of me here, this is a backflow preventer. One of the common questions I get from customers is, why do we have and why do we need a backflow preventer? And this is something I feel that both plumbers, local water purveyors, and local municipalities, we have not done a good job educating the public as to the importance of why we need a backflow preventer. So the reason why we have backflow preventers and what they are is a backflow preventer is a check valve or a series of check valves. This unit actually has two check valves and then a relief port that actually will empty the water. So what the backflow does and what the check valves do is they allow water to only go one way. So the water can go from the municipal water supply into your home, but never back towards the municipal water supply. The reason for this is we want to protect the municipal water supply to keep everyone healthy and safe. So the biggest reasons we have backflow preventers are to protect one of two things: back pressure, so pressure pushing back from your home into the municipal water supply, which is pretty extremely rare, or back siphonage, which is a more common occurrence. So what back siphonage is and why we need to be careful about that is, if say you are, so we're in Florida, lots of people have pools. So let's say you're filling your pool and you've got your garden hose down inside your pool, and maybe you've had to add some chemicals to shock it recently, or another good example would be you have a pest control company come out and they need to mix their chemicals to spray your lawn for pests. So especially on a pest control side, if they aren't careful and they don't have the equipment set up and they don't know, then if they stick their garden hose down inside of their bucket or their mixing tank and the water's running and they've got that hose in there and they're mixing the water and their chemicals, then what happens is if there's a water main break on the municipal water supply out in the street, or if the fire department has to open a water hydrant to flush the system, or new construction's going on and they open the water fire hydrants to flush the water out, that's going to create a negative pressure. So it's going to decrease the water pressure. When that happens, if you don't have a backflow preventer, when someone's got their garden hose in their pool running, or in that pesticide container mixing with chemicals, if that water's running with that hose and that contaminated water at the same time that there's a water main break or a fire hydrant gets opened, it's going to suck that contaminated and polluted water back from your home through to the municipal water supply and potentially get someone sick, or people have even in rare cases died from that. So that is the importance of backflow prevention. That's why we have them. That's why they also need to be tested on an annual basis to make sure that they're working properly, because there's a series of springs and check valves in here. And over time, those springs can get stuck, and they get stuck in the open position. And when that happens, if it's not been tested, no one knows. And so if they're stuck in the open position and we have a backflow scenario, a back siphonage occurs, the backflow preventer doesn't do any good, and then people get sick. So thanks for taking a few minutes to watch this video. I hope you found it educational.